GridView allows you to make layouts like this, and this, and this, and this. And no, these aren't just photos, these are actual layouts built in FlutterFlow. So let me show you how to use this powerful widget. So we've got a new page here, and let's come in and add a grid view. And we can't really see anything that's going on inside here, so let's just drop in a container. Let's give it a nice color. And then let's duplicate these with Command D so we can actually see the grid. Beautiful. Okay, let's go back into our grid view and let's look at some of these properties. So you want to use a grid view when you need a grid with children that are the same aspect ratio. So like square or 16:9, like a YouTube thumbnail, or maybe like horizontal or vertical photos. Now the first option here is whether you want your grid to scroll horizontally or vertically. By default, it scrolls vertically. So this means once this grid view overflows its parent, which direction do you want it to scroll? Now here, the parent is just our homepage, our scaffold, our main body. But of course, if you wrapped your grid view in something else, say a container, and let's just turn off this color and pull it out a little bit, then it'll scroll whenever it's filled up that max constraint from its parent. So here it's set to vertical, but we could switch it and set it to horizontal, in which case we would scroll horizontally. Now, when I switch the axis, you saw that the layout changed, and we'll talk about that in a minute, but let's switch it back to vertical scrolling, and let's get rid of this container for the time being. Okay, so we've set our main axis, so it's scrolling vertically. And the next property you want to set is this cross axis count. And so if our main axis is vertical, then our cross axis is horizontal. And so you're telling the grid view, hey, how many cross axis sections, or in this case, how many columns do you want? And we have it set to 3. Now, if we change this to, let's say, 4, that two things happen. First, we get 4 columns now. But the other thing is that the size of our children changes. And that's because our grid view passes down these size constraints to its children. So the grid view is what determines the size of the children, not the children themselves. And this is the beauty of the grid view, because this is what allows you to have a clean, consistent grid. Okay, so we have our scrolling direction, we have how many columns we want. Now, let's jump over our spacing and set our child aspect ratio. And the aspect ratio is a property commonly used in film and photography that is the relationship between the width and the height of each child, but expressed as a decimal or integer. So you'll commonly see this in videos with like 1920:1080 or a 16:9 aspect ratio. So these are square because by default we have a 1:1, 1/1 aspect ratio, so 1 unit horizontally by 1 unit vertically. But let's say you were displaying YouTube thumbnails here and you wanted a 16:9 aspect ratio. Well, then you could just pull out your calculator and do 16 ÷ 9 and then use that decimal. So 1.77. Great. But now our children are a little bit too small. But remember, the size of our children is determined by our axis count. So right now we've got 4 columns. So let's bump it down to 3. And now we have a more legible grid. Or if you wanted to show more TikTok style thumbnails with their vertical aspect ratio, this would just be inversed. Next, you've got your spacing. And the spacing is your tracks, the gaps between your columns and your rows. So now we're at 10:10. But maybe you want them tighter, like in the Apple Photos app. So let's just put this down to 2. Now, maybe instead you want a horizontally scrolling interface. And the main thing to keep in mind there is that when you switch it, two things are going to change. First, the axes are going to change. So the main axis is horizontal. And so the cross axis will not be columns, but now it'll be rows. So we have 3. So now each new child is going to be stacked horizontally. And second, the child aspect ratio will be switched. And so now it's not width by height, it's height by width. So if we wanted to display those TikTok style vertical thumbnails, then we would switch this. Next, we've got our shrink wrap property. And to show this, let's simplify this layout a little bit. Okay, so now we have the children not filling up the screen right here. And you can see by this green border that GridView is taking up as much space as its parent allows, which is just the homepage right now. But if you wanted to shrink down to its children, you turn on shrink wrap, and you can see that jumps up. This is an important fix to know if your grid view is inside a widget like a column or a row or a list view that's looking for its child for its size. So right now, if I wrap my grid view in a column, everything's fine, and that's because I have shrink wrap turned on. If I turn shrink wrap off, the app's gonna crash. So let's watch this go up in flames. Boom. FlutterFlow has reversed this action because it would have crashed the app. And this is because the column is looking to the child for the height and the grid view is saying, I want all the height possible, infinite height. And so it crashes. So if you're having this problem, make sure that you have your grid view set to shrink wrap. Lastly, let's take a look at some of those common layouts that use a grid view. Here, we've got our Apple Photos app. And in this layout, we've got a stack widget so that we can overlay this content up here. And then we've got our grid view, which is our main body here, with all our images and just a little bit of spacing. Having small spacing is sometimes helpful too for tap targets, so that anywhere the user taps, they're gonna get the image. And so there's little or no gap that would not register a click. Next, we've got Apple Podcasts. This is a great example of the use of a more horizontal aspect ratio. And when paired with a hero animation transition, this is a really elegant UI solution. Next up, Calculator. Yep, this is built in a grid view, and I've just got a grid of buttons. Really fun and easy to set up. Finally, we've got the TikTok search page. This is a great example of the vertical aspect ratio. Vertical video is very popular, and this is an easy way to display a consistent grid of vertical images or videos. We'd love to see what you build with GridView. Drop us a link in the comments or leave any questions you might have, and we'll see you in the next video.